Hi folks, welcome back to part 2 of season 2. We're about to go into what is tagged as an easy mission, but frankly, it's definitely gonna not be an easy mission. It may just be the most difficult mission of all time. The reason I say that is because every single pod on the mission is gonna be comprised of at least 4 enemies and a mixture of advent and alien contact. It's not going to be the easy run that we quite often have, predictable troopers, etc. It's going to be pretty savage. Because we've got the fatigue running, we should really, in theory, be not taking any fatigue troops with us, because that's going to give them a wound and it's going to mean that they're going to be incapacitated for even longer after this mission. But I just didn't feel comfortable taking 6 rookies on this mission because it's going to be pretty hairy. So we're taking 2 of our already leveled up squaddies. We're going to bring the sniper, Christine Clark, and we're going to bring Hunter, who's our necromancer. Hopefully they're going to give us a little bit of versatility in this otherwise all rookie squad. Now, the only other thing that I'm doing here to hopefully balance the books a little bit is we've given 1, 2, 3 of our rookies, we've given them battle rifle, which will slow them down even further, and we only get 3 shots per clip, but they do more damage.
Sky Ranger deployed.
We're in the pipe, 5x5.
A resistance operative managed to rig up some sort of data interception device through an access point on the Advent network running through here. The data is apparently critical to the aliens' latest operation, and they're already moving to destroy the device. We're heading in to make sure that doesn't happen. Take out any hostile targets nearby, secure the AO, and protect that device.
This potentially is going to be very, very difficult. And I keep saying that, I guess I'm just bricking my pants.
I'm really not doing too well
with how scared I am. Alright. What?
Hostile forces are already moving to destroy the data tap installed
Advent
nearby.
Recon drone
sectoid. We need to lock down the area and secure the device at all costs.
Okay, so we've got a lot of high ground, but actually it's going to be a lot of fairly close combat, close range fighting here potentially because of the height of these buildings. So we have to watch how we trigger pods and how we engage them. Like, we could easily accidentally trigger more than one pod here if we're not careful. So let's get our sniper up into position first of all.
Ooh. I'm on the move.
Yeah. Fabrizio, so you can see, you should be able to see down there, right? Yeah, okay, so why don't you come along here? We don't have a scout, unfortunately, it's a bit of a shame. Yeah, that's not cover, so why don't you push on up? Bridget Hunter. I would actually quite like to leave someone on Overwatch. She's got a shotgun. She's pretty sweet.
Moving out.
I think I'm going to put Timothy Cheese on Overwatch up on top here, just in case something does get triggered and something spots us. It would be nice to have at least a shot on
Overwatch.
And why don't you come down here?
On the move.
So we don't really know how long we've got for this mission because it's one of these protect the device missions. So I guess we'll see in a moment. Do I want a steady weapon? Or actually maybe move out a bit further, because we'll get a better line of sight down that corridor then. Let's move over a bit further.
Heading to that location.
I'm happy that we've got a sniper on the team at least. Now then, listening out for contact. There's a door opening. Did he even hit it? What just happened?
What?
Looks like we've got a few turns yet then. Now, where's the ladder here? It's up that side. Okay, so we need to get intel without triggering too much. See, what I'm worried about is here we've got, we've probably got likely to have three pods, I'm guessing. Could be more. But the device is there. We know there's a pod there shooting at it. There could easily be two pods here, and we really can't handle more than one very easily. So we do need to be on alert. Maybe we can open the door there to get a better idea of what's around. Okay, so we know it's basically safe to come through there.
Got it.
Time to motor.
As before, I'm going to leave a little bit of Overwatch just in case. Got some pretty good rookies though, even though we've got a squad full of rookies. Look, Daniel has got aim of 74. He's only got mobility 10 because he's got a battle rifle, as well as having terrible mobility in general. But Daniel has got 74 aim, which is amazing for a rookie. So maybe
it
might be sort of okay if we're lucky. Alright, can we get up there? I mean, it might be a bit risky going around there right now. Maybe we'll start next turn by doing that. Just take some Overwatch for now.
Enemy activity!
Okay. Something ahead. Oh, cool. Demolitionist, a sectoid recon drone, and a gunslinger. Oh, we don't want to blow up that heavy cover there. That's a lovely corner spot for us to then advance and attack that area. Wouldn't it be lovely to grenade that lot? Oh, no such luck. All right, let's open that door anyway. Wow, we are very slow.
Headed there now.
Okay, we can see all four of them. We know it's a pod of four, so that means that this intel we're getting from the red spaces is good. Sometimes if you can't see all of them, you don't know exactly how far you can move forward. But in this case, I think we're good to come all the way up here.
I'm all over it.
What we're going to do is move up this turn in preparation for ambush on next turn.
Posizione confermata.
On the move.
I'm hoping that's safe. They might somehow move into a flank. If they decide to come up this ladder, obviously we're going to be a bit stuck.
Got it covered.
On Overwatch.
Okay, not too bad. I'm kind of okay with our setup here.
Stepping off.
Now, sniper pants. Do we... Are we going to be able to get any shots from here? Potentially. We could move down here for a better chance. Just don't feel 100% sure about that. No, I'm just going to steady weapon again this turn. Just to be safe. Whoa, they're sprinting. Okay, well, we've still got a few turns left on that by the look of it. How much damage? I've done it. Some damage. It's got loads of health left, 30. So we've got like quite a few more turns, which is really nice. We can open the fight with a grenade. We haven't got eyes on all of them. Wonder if we can get some cheaty style information. Okay, let's have a look. Okay. Let's just confirm that. Okay, so it looks like the other two are here and here. Either side of this post thing. And that means we can't get all of them with a grenade. We can only hit three of them. Still, three of them isn't a bad thing to be hitting. Especially considering this person's behind cover. I think that's really nice. Right, apart from that though, we don't have that much good cover here. Daniel's in the perfect position there to go on Overwatch because he's got heavy cover. And we're going to do the same with Spider, actually. Yeah. Move them around here into heavy cover. Go on Overwatch.
Eyes on the prize.
Okay, I think that's it for the Overwatch. I don't want to go too hard on the Overwatch because we might miss them, and it could be that these lot scatter and we don't get a shot at all on them, and that would really suck. So, all right, here we go. Fingers crossed.
Granada. Siamo stati avvistati.
All right, give us some Overwatch now, people. I love the sound of that battle rifle. It's so awesome. Okay, well, that's good. We can take out the gunslinger with poison. As long as we don't move. So we can take a 62% shot on the demolitionist. What else have we got here? We could flashbang the sectoid. What shots has our sniper got on? Behind full cover. Oh no, it's only behind half cover somehow. Well, let's take that shot anyway. It's the best we've really got with our sniper. Unlucky.
Come on, focus.
Right, in which case you're going to do poison on the gunslinger. Giving her a new helmet, sweet, huh? I figured it'd be nice to do something special since she's the necromancer. She looked like an awesome kind of assault or proper normal soldier before, which is the sort of class I've had her in the past. But I figured we'd do something a little bit different. All right, 62%. This is 260% shots on the same soldier. Critical, lovely. Oh.
Enemy destroyed.
So who have we got left? Just Captain Timothy, jeez, the captain, as he's known. So we should probably move you into full cover. Moving it's just a regular out. Old sectoid. So let's put you on Overwatch. It's moving likely to do some kind of psychic ability. Yeah, that poison has seen that, has done for that gunslinger, which is nice. That's okay, we can handle that. Just don't shoot your friends.
This is alright!
Alright, cool. That was alright. Ooh, so far so good. Wow. So, what are we going to do here then? We need to deal with that sectoid, of course. We haven't got any... Probably the best bet is going to be to grenade the cover from out behind him. We want to be wary of triggering anything else this turn, though. Also, we're going to run out of grenades pretty quickly at this rate. Right, you're probably going to move out to there. We can't quite get a flank on the sectoid, and that side's burning quite badly. Okay, we're just gonna have to go for the grenade. Can we hit it from here? No, we can only get the cover from here. Alright, let's try someone else. Mr. Cheese, I reckon you've probably got this. Let's have a little look here. Yeah, lovely.
Get ready.
Do you like
surprise.
Cricket, sir? One googly coming right up. Perfect. I was half expecting that we were going to trigger something else now behind the sectoid through that huge hole, but no, we're good. Battle rifles are so cool. Obviously, that's from a mod that I've installed. There, you get the battle rifles and the marksman's rifle or something, whatever that one's called. Basically, the similar, same weapons that we saw in Long War. In fact, they've been slightly tweaked. The battle rifle is much, they're slightly different actually. The battle rifle gives you increased aim at medium to long-ish range. When I say long-ish range, I mean like towards the edge of squad of where you'd run out of vision of where squad sight would begin. I'm not going to move with that person as much as I want to. And it does a bit more damage at the cost of mobility. And the marksman's rifle actually has an aim penalty the whole time, but it allows you to move and fire. A bit like as if you had the snapshot ability, but slightly different the way it works. It feels like quite a harsh penalty though. It's the minus 15%, so I'm not sure if I'm liking it or not. Oh, I really want to take that position on the roof there. Let's have a look. It's still not too damaged, that building. So why don't we do a move up, see what happens.
Vado in posizione.
Even though that fire might go out next turn. All cover, that's nice.
Closing on target position now. Moving on target location.
We may have triggered something here.
Got some advent here.
An advent heavy, a demolitionist, a sectoid, and a recon drone. Crap. Right, we're not really set up to deal with this pod right now. Let's see what we can do though. Open that door, it might put the fire out. Not so far. Okay. We've got a shot on the recon drone, 84%. Let's take that. Amazing, oh my goodness.
Bersaglio neutralizzato.
Daniel, can you get to anywhere else that's in heavy cover? No. Can anyone get a flank on that sectoid, I wonder? But you got a shot on it from here. Got a shot on the sectoid. Advent heavy, 50%. 50% chance, but not a guaranteed kill. So I suspect the demolitionist is a better target. Because if we do hit, then we're going to definitely kill him. So let's shoot the demolitionist with our 50% chance.
I got nothing. My ammo's running low.
No such luck. Okay. Well, we're going to poison the Advent Heavy to give him minus 30 to aim, because we really don't want him to get us. We really don't want him to take advantage of that height that he's got there. Poisoned him, great. Okay. Yeah. Daniel. I think maybe, mate, you can just give us some Overwatch, might be the best shout. Can't quite get a flank on the sectoid. Just need to move a little bit further forward to do that. I don't want to move out of that heavy cover position that we've got there, really. Oh, I just pressed the wrong button with him. Crap. I meant to have a shot with that person. Oh, that wasn't very good. 25%. 25% and not a lot else. I think redeploying is going to be your best bet. Oh, I don't know exactly where the best bot for you to go to is going to be. You've only got 3 health though, which sucks. So you need to be very careful here. Let's have a little look in this building on that second floor, please. No. Yeah, that's the floor for us. So, or is that the ground? No, that's the ground. Here we go. Okay, so you could potentially run out to there and get some nice snipe, but there's a windows. Okay, no, I don't like it. Oh well, in which case, I'm just gonna get you to Overwatch. There's only windows along this side. So potentially you could get a shot on something that ran across here and on the sector if it decided to move. So rather than take a 25% shot chance that we know can't kill the sector, I think we'd be better off overwatching. What are they going to do? That ain't good. Oh, they've overwatched as well. Thanks.
It's inside me.
All right. How far can you throw that flashbang? Kind of far. If you can get into position somehow, Daniel, you should be able to chuck. How far much further do you need? I mean, you need further than 3 squares, which is what you'd get if you go here. 1, 2 only, actually. How about that? That looks okay, but are you going to get shot to death with Overwatch? Alright, who's going to take one for the team here? Not Bridget. She's very valuable. Well, we need to move up into more full cover. Maybe we can do Timothy, the captain. Maybe you can do a hero move, run all the way. That might trigger another pod though. Bloody hell. We've got to do something. Get rid of that mind control. That's the priority. We need to get rid of the mind control, or our own friendly is going to start really messing us up. That would be a nice spot. Can you get there? See, this is now the downside of having really slow troops. It's a big downside. All right, Captain, run that Overwatch for us. Are you ready? Keep your head down and run as fast as you can. Oh, okay, go, go, go. We're taking a yellow move here. Okay, good. So far, so good. Oh, a of course, the first guy had penalty to his aim, so it wasn't that bad of a move. This one was likely to miss, and he did, but it was the demolitionist which hit, and he's now only on one health, which sucks. But on the other side, we should, in theory, now be able to get that sectoid with a flashbang.
That's affirmative.
And if we're lucky, someone else too. No, we can't get anyone else. But we can get the sectoid, which is great.
Better close your eyes.
But that's a lot of actions on our part just to deal with mind control. So that ain't good. But it does give our friend here his turn. He can get a flank on the sectoid and possibly chuck out a grenade. Well, the sectoid is now flanked. Not flanked, is now flashbanged. So his chances of him hitting with his pistol shot are much reduced. So the other two enemies are now more of a concern. If you can move out to there, Christine, that would be great. Okay, what can we do? The thing I'm struggling with here is I don't want to put this person into half cover. If that was full cover, I'd do this in a jiffy, but I want to be able to move them out and use the grenade that they have. But we can't get them into proper cover. That's what I'm worrying about here. It also might trigger the last pod or another pod, and that would be potentially fatal for us. So why don't we just come round to here and get the flank shot on the sectoid instead? We've got two people in heavy cover around here as well now. There's some chance we might be able to hit him with a frag now. We can't. Okay, I thought that was probably going to happen, but 90%. Let's take that. Safe is that roof looking? Not particularly, but we can move up there and take a shot probably.
Confirmo.
All right, 62% chance. That's definitely worth trying. Yes. Oh, amazing. Fabrizio, you're a total hero. Oh, that was good, man. Well done. We can move up to here with Rolling. Bridget. I'm very wary of that ground, though. Perhaps not wary enough, by the looks of it. Okay, I'm just going to overwatch with Bridget.
On overwatch.
Okay, so that's poisoned and that's disorientated. Hopefully the incoming fire isn't going to be too much of an issue for us here. Oh, I'm proper scared. Yes! Oh, I can't believe that this is sort of going okay. I'm flabbergasted. Oh, I just was really scared. The ceiling had fallen in on our heroes there. You can get a reload spider. Where's the sniper? Here we go.
Ready to rock.
29%, not great. 43% from Fabrizio. This is the man that can hit anything. He's unstoppable. Unstoppable.
Nemico distrutto.
Okay, great. Wow. Oh, wow. Okay, we can take half a breath, I think.
Moving out.
Why don't you reload, and you can reload also.
Ready to engage.
You can overwatch. You can overwatch.
It's coming. Overwatch.
On overwatch.
We can maybe open the door. And now overwatch.
Scanning.
And steady that rifle, please, soldier. So there should be another pod back there. Actually, they're not taking shots at this anymore. Fabrizio, get yourself a much deserved reload, my friend.
Ricaricato.
Okay, so this turn we're just gonna, we're not on too much of a timer now then, since they've stopped shooting at the relay. Here we go, Daniel, can you move to cover? Oh, you can't move to cover, you're slow. 10, movement 10. We're just so slow, oh dear.
Understood, moving out.
Okay, well, I actually don't want to move up then this turn. I want to get some better positions before we do so.
Got it covered.
Moving to overwatch.
Overwatch.
You can come up here, I think. Oh, if we trigger something, it doesn't seem likely that we'll trigger something by coming up here, does it? Let's give that a go.
Move.
Okay, let's start moving forward. Where's all that heavy cover that we need? There's a bit here, but it's explodable, which ain't good. Daniel, you can at least move up and take this nice corner spot there, huh?
Headed there now.
This'll do. That's good. You, sir, I don't want you in any more trouble than you're already in. Why don't you go to that corner?
Move.
Right, that might just be enough movement for one turn. Overwatch.
Monta la guardia,
I'm on
heavy
it.
Weapon.
There's something out there.
I was just going to say, it sounds like it's coming over from the right-hand side. It's obviously another sectoid. So let's redeploy people over to this right area. Since this building is falling to pieces down here.
Heading there now.
Okay.
D'accordo.
Heading to that location.
Scanning.
Should take a reload, Daniel. And else.
We're green to
go. Lipo.
Good copy. Moving on target.
All right, Overwatch.
Come get some.
Got it covered.
I've got movement. Heads up.
All right, are they coming this way, or are they just sort of moving around back there? Who knows? Are they coming? No.
Mi muovo.
Nothing. Okay, so someone can move forward, I think, and have a look what's out there.
Good copy. Moving on target. On overwatch.
Okay.
Alright, this is the one that might make something happen. Nope. Okay, well, I'm fine with that. Taking it nice and easy here, since we're not on a timer.
Scanning.
As such right now.
I've got movement, heads up.
I think they are moving around back there. Yeah, here we go. Sectoid trooper recon drone. Okay. Unlucky.
Enemy is still up. Advent forces sighted.
Nice. I'm loving this firing squad from the... Oh, yes! Good night, Sector. I'm loving the firing gang we've got set up all around this building, multiple floors. Still, they're quite well entrenched there themselves now, aren't they? Alright, let's have a little look then. So there's a drone plus two troopers. What have we got in the way of grenades? We've got a grenade over here from Spider. But like, it's gonna do nothing unless we really make some forward moves with him. Yeah, there's not really any kind of better position for him though than he, I mean, we could go there, I guess, but that's obviously super flankable. Still, would it allow us to get a grenade? Stop moving around, camera. We are 1, 2, 3, 4, sort of five squares shy of that grenade working very well. So that's only 1, 2, 3, 4. So we can't actually get him into a decent grenade position. So I think we're going to abandon his grenade. That person with the grenade is too far away. Bridget might be able to pull something out. But actually, I want to use poison with her. So let's poison that trooper at the back. And we'll have to forego grenades this turn. We should be able to, with our height advantage and decent aim bonuses on everybody, we should be able to... Well, we might be able to do something with this lot. At least if we can take out that bottom advent trooper and set some overwatch for that drone, we might be cool here. Alright, who needs kills? Christine, take that one, please. Through the building. Lovely.
Good riddance.
Well, you can't shoot anything, so you can just overwatch for me, please.
Covering now.
Do we want you to move up and try something? Why not? You might get a shot on if you... Lucky, no, nothing.
Affirmative, covering now.
11% is basically rubbish, so.
Affirmative, covering now.
Daniel, Overwatch. Okay, so we can expect the drone to make a move on us to some degree. And I don't know what the trooper will do. He's poisoned, so he's not going to have a great shot on us. He's probably going to move up to here and take a shot. No, Overwatch, huh? No sign of that drone. Did we take the drone down? I don't know. Oh, well, we do need to move up at some point. He's on Overwatch. He is poisoned, though. No one's got a shot on him, though, have they? No, not a person. Do we take the risk of running that Overwatch? If we sprint, he's less likely to hit us. Plus, it's an Overwatch shot, so he's got a penalty already. Plus, he's got a penalty of 30. So we should be safe if we run this Overwatch.
Affirmative. We've got eyes on the objective.
Menace 1-5, we've got a line on the target. Move to protect that gear at
Thanks,
all costs.
We already knew where it was anyway, mate, but still, we're not going to complain for the info. Odd.
Heading out.
There's that drone. 69%. That's worth taking.
That armor's tough. Weapons burning ammo fast.
Fabrizio. Well, you're going to not move anywhere because you're so super hurt. But Fabrizio, you could potentially move up a little bit and get a shot on that drone as well.
Ordine ricevuto.
What we want to watch out for here is that trooper coming out and trying to take a shot on us soon. Another 62.
Got it covered.
Let's do it, team.
non farà più male a nessuno.
I'm moving our sniper over because if we can get eyes on that last guy, we should be able to take him down with squad sight next turn. We really want that loot. Oh my god, we want that loot so much. Is he going to overwatch?
They're backing up, advance!
Here he comes. There he goes. Oh my goodness.
Enemy eliminated.
Oh crap, there's another bot out there. Oh, that ain't good. That ain't good.
Orders confirmed. Moving out.
I think we just found it.
I've got eyes on an advent position.
Oh, right control. Gunslinger, recon drone trooper. Bleh. That's bad news.
Bitch.
They don't realise how much we want our loot either. What's the rest of the game doing? They're just going to chill? They're just hanging back there. Having a great time. Okay, Bridget is in a bit of trouble now. So, you need some backup. Oh, we need that loot. Seriously. We can't keep going through turns like this and not getting loot. Alright, 69 is a good effort. Oh, sniper really isn't quite hitting the mark. You're just going to have to stay back and overwatch, man. You're 100 miles from the fight, sadly, but one of you two can definitely move up into some proper cover. Yeah, Fabrizio.
Ci vado subito.
Can you... Ooh, now that is tempting. Oh, hang on a minute. He's behind heavy cover because of that, obviously because of that stairs, and that's only half cover, man. So we won't be able to blow that stairs up with a grenade. That's a shame. Spider, if you come here, I don't think he's going to be able to get a flank. Or, oh, he could run across here. Maybe. I'm not sure if he'll be able to see there, though. Let's give it a go. That means he's going to have to run some overwatch anyway. On the move. 44. 51. I really want to take that shot. In order for me to feel safe taking that shot, we're going to have to mess up this right control at least somewhat.
Together. Out of ammo here.
So you're gonna have to overwatch and Mr. Murphy, what are you gonna do for us, mate? I guess you can move down there for now.
Moving out.
You're gonna need to poison the right control. I was thinking, oh, we've got through this okay, it's been alright. Actually, this last pod could be bad for us. Bloody marked us as well now. Wow, that's a slow recon drone. Oh, we're only in half cover and we're marked now. That ain't good. Oh, what? Look how far away we were and behind heavy cover. No, Daniel. No, 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 no. Crap. Oh, it just got horrible. Oh, my God. We need a... freaking loot. I'm so annoyed about the loot situation. balls. Half cover isn't acceptable. Oh, bollocks.
We're green to go.
Well, might as well take that one. It's the highest chance to hit out of the two shots. Can't hit anything, can you? What's wrong with you?
Missed.
Okay, you've taken no damage. Oh, you've taken one damage, Bridget. And we're marked as well, so we're probably not safe. Oh, this sucks. 50%. Try and take that Overwatch down.
Adjusting sights.
We just can't do it. Cannot hit them.
Barto.
Here he goes. Yeah, he's got a penalty to of 30 to his Overwatch shot chance, but we just need to clone this man.
Bersaglio eliminato.
Fabrizio Lazzaro, just a one-man team of nutters. Oh, God, we're in trouble here. We can't get the freaking loot out. Oh, I'm gonna just complain every day for the rest of my life. We keep missing the loot.
Got it covered.
So what do we do? We literally can't get the loot. If you go back there, you should be able to. Let's have a little look. You should be able to get a shot on the gunslinger or the riot control.
Roger that.
Well, 60% versus 28. It's not much of a question, really, is it? Good. See you later, mister.
Target neutralized.
No loot. All right, I'm gonna not complain. Maybe once more. Something wrong with that drone. Seriously.
I'm all right.
I'm glad the gunslinger missed. And, okay. This is definitely the last pod. Oh, if only we had some kind of melee charge unit, but we sadly don't. All right, what about our failed sniper? Oh, you need a reload. Well, this is not that useful. You need a reload.
Back online.
Pronto far fuoco.
See, I think that you need to move up a bit, Bridget, here. Where can you go? Because we need you to get eyes on the, there we go.
Position
on the gunsling
confirmed.
And on the drone, there we go. So 42, I think you're probably gonna be better off if we wait to take your turn, because we can move up with some of the others here.
I'm on the move.
Spider, Daniel, you're only on one health, buddy. You all right, man? Can you get a shot on anything from there? No. And from
heading
there.
To that location.
Well, he's very flankable there, unfortunately. But 68% is pretty good.
the armor. I need ammo.
Well, you can't hit anything this turn, sadly. Otherwise, everything would be dead. Okay, move up there.
Heading out.
This is like the golden frag grenade. Oh, you can't quite make it. Oh, I thought you had that. Oh, dude, that ain't good. Can you at least hurt that guy? No. All right, well, we still should be okay here. It's a worthwhile grenade.
Overwatch.
Let's go, 82%, that looks nice. So we've got just the drone to worry about.
It's down.
We do have some Overwatch, but not. Overwatch isn't that reliable against drones, so whoa. Uh-oh, this could be the death of Daniel. Missed. Look out. Oh, no. What's it going to do to Bridget? Oh. Okay, run out of everything. This should be easy to sort out. Thanks for coming. Status confirmed. Come on.
Status confirmed.
Yeah.
All hostiles are down and the area is secure. Status confirmed. Mission accomplished.
Amazing. Well, we definitely took a bit of a beating, but we somehow pulled through. Well, we made it. Well done, gang. Oh, sorry looking bunch now, though. Ooh, there's a few wounded people here. These two look wounded, even though it doesn't appear like Wolverine is, and that's because we took them out when they were fatigued, so they're going to take an extra point of wound there as well. So we've got 12 days plus whatever else that's going to be wounded. So we've got a lot of fatigue happening here. Also, a lot of fatigue, which is a shame. However, on the plus side, we do have 6 brand new promotions. Let's have a look what they got here. A Shinobi, Yima, Spider, nice. Bit slow perhaps for a Shinobi, but lots of health and amazing aim, so we can probably do a lot with that. Grenadier from Fabrizio with amazing aim. Well, maybe we'll have to make some sort of special grenadier out of you, which has got all these gun things. I doubt it though, but maybe I'll have a look at it anyway. Okay, Christine, well done for your promotion. You get precision shot. Hunter, Bridget Hunter, nice. Okay, so this is a tough choice here for this level 2 necromancer for corporal. Combustion is great, it does direct damage. Guaranteed 2-4 damage and sets them on fire. That's really, really good. That is super good. Well, I'm almost talking myself into that. So let's have a little look at Undead Link. I'm basically probably going to take Raid Zombie. I thought I was going to take Raid Zombie, and I didn't think I was going to have to think about this. Because the great thing about Raid Zombie is it gives you an additional thing for the enemy to fire at. And you can just sort of blunder it out there in front of the enemy guns. And that's an extra meat shield for us, literally a meat shield. So the benefit of that is huge, actually. It's really, really big. Oh, they're both so good. I want both of those. Undead Link makes the zombie better. Combustion just seems so good. Guaranteed damage 2-4. Ooh. Still, we're going to go zombie. We are a necromancer after all. We're going to go zombie. I would like to see that combustion in action though. We've got a phantom. And we've got a spec op, sorry, with Timothy Cheese. How you doing, Timothy? This is an undercover kind of covert ops specialist. And they do start with Phantom, which is wonderful. He's pretty wounded, though, which is a shame. I was hoping to get somebody with Phantom ready for the next mission, if possible. Still, welcome. Well done to you for your promotion. Not got the best aim. And pretty slow, which is a shame. both of which are helpful traits for a Spec Ops. Murphy, rogue, with amazing aim. Again, not the greatest of mobility, but that's okay. Cool, so rogue and the Spec Ops are both new classes, and you can find them in the description. You can find them in the Steam Workshop group that I've created with all the different mods that we're using. But I love the look of rogue. Could be really an interesting class. Definitely not overpowered. I've had a look through it and it seems kind of cool. It's going to be interesting having somebody with such high aim as a rogue. He doesn't yet have the ability to stealth with conceal, for example. So I'm going to consider how to build this person. I've never done it before, but potentially we might want to build him slightly differently to the standard rogue. Yeah, we'll see. All right. Drone corpse. That's the big bald dude. Hello to you, sir. Glad to see you're still going. Contact the black site resistance region. We've got an engine here. That is lovely. Okay, so I'm not going to put somebody in. I'm not going to put our new engineer in the guerrilla tactics school. I'm going to start clearing debris because the main thing I want the guerrilla tactics school for ASAP is to give us squad size upgrade, and unfortunately we need to get somebody to sergeant, and that's going to be some time still before we're able to do that. If we have a look, our two corporals who are one promotion away from sergeant are now 12 and 9 days wounded, and then they've got this fatigue as well to deal with, so they're a long way away. We've got these two who are both 6 days out from fatigue. Well, we might have to take another rookie squad on the next mission. That's the thing I'm finding quite tricky when I think about what the next mission's going to be.
Commander,
there's the black site.
We have a lead on the alien black site, but we'll have to rely on the local resistance to actually get us into the facility.
Interesting.
We should try to make contact with their forces in the region as soon as possible. It's the only way we're going to find out what's behind this so-called Avatar project.
Commander,
we should
you're
do
not
so.
Gonna believe this. We just picked up a signal from an emergency locator beacon.
I don't believe
it's definitely one of ours, from the original invasion. I know it sounds crazy, but if there's any chance some of our people could still be out there, I think we owe it to them to find out.
Expires in 9 days. Wow, this is a tough one. Alright, what we're going to do is this.
Avenger plotting new course.
We need, in order to do the next mission, if we finish that, that's going to give us a mission, because don't forget we're using the new scanning sites plus. Oh, I forgot to do something. Crap. Okay, oops. Pressed escape too many times there. We want to go into living quarters and put people in fatigue recovery. Let's do Shane, because he's an assault, isn't he? And we really want him to get better sooner rather than later. Let's have a quick 4 days for Shane.
What can I do for you, Commander?
Oh, that was amazing. You can actually go straight to personnel from there. I like that. So obviously, of course, this is a new mod. Oh, that's wonderful. Well done, the person who made this mod. Because you've got the fatigue times here, and you can also click straight away to get to the soldiers. What I'm debating here, the reason that I'm hesitating, is because if we get that facility lead, we're going to need to send a squad out. And I would prefer not to have to send a rookie squad on that mission. But then we're going to have another mission coming up soon, which is usually a risky, the VIP mission. And we don't want to send a full rookie squad out there either. So that's a bit scary, really. Let's stick Fabrizio. Fabrizio's his grenadier. We want Fabrizio back in action ASAP, regardless of whatever, what anything else that happens. 3 days for Shane, 5 days for Kavita. Okay. I We don't want to leave. We want to keep doing the recovered cargo, please. Okay, great. Ooh.
I take it this was easier than your last procedure, Doctor.
Yeah.
Central.
New objective added.
I'm keeping tabs on all our operations.
It's also unlocked Spec Ops throwing knife.
People are standing by for your orders.
The Advent captain seems to provide a means of stabilizing the link between the local subordinates and the Advent network tower itself.
Commander, if we're going to try to build this skulljack that Tigan came up with, we're going to need a specialized facility to test it out.
All right, let's crack on with distance comms. Oh, that would give us battle scanners, but we'll get that later.
I had assumed you'd make that research a priority, Commander. I'll notify you as soon as the report is available.
So let's finish this off.
You and I both know we only had one other Sky Ranger, Commander. It's worse for wear, but this heap used to be Big Sky's pride and joy, and someone's been putting her to work. It may be possible to triangulate exactly where they took off from, but it'll take some time.
Commander. Oh. These weapons are unlike any design I have previously encountered before. I could attempt further analysis, but the likelihood of us reverse engineering them appears low regardless.
No problem, folks. Thanks for all that information. So this is great. It's the first time I've actually had the new weapons that are available from
Avenger plotting new course.
From the Alien Hunters DLC. And they're pretty cool. Some interesting. It's going to give us a few extra tools that we desperately need right now. Okay, here comes this first mission. So, this is a scientist with... it's going to give us some intel. But right off the back of this, we're going to need to do this other mission to give us the facility lead.
Setting course for the Mexican Regional Tract.
Remember what Tigan said. These new weapons are one of a kind. If we leave them on the battlefield, they'll be
amazing.
Lost to us forever.
Boltcaster, Shadowkeeper, Hunter's Axe, and Frost Bomb. Some very cool new equipment I'm really excited that we've got now. Okay, lovely. Well, I need to do a bit of thinking about exactly how we're going to play this particular next mission. As you can see, we've still got quite a few people fatigued here. And coming off of this mission, we're then going to very soon want to go into that other mission, and of course that's going to create its own set of fatigue people, and I don't want to take a full squad of rookies on either mission. So I'll have a bit of a think about that. Thanks so much. If you're enjoying the video so far, please do consider giving it a little thumbs up or subscribing to the channel if you haven't already. I will see you back very soon for the next part. Take care.